here are some crazy cool rocks you can use to condition your hands. Every Taekwondo fighter or any Taekwondo practitioner should work on conditioning their hands so they can punch really hard in a self-defense situation. If you punch someone's skull and you don't have conditioned hands, you have a tendency to fracture your knuckles. Practicing hand conditioning is going to make it to where you can hit someone in the head, like on their, if you accidentally hit them on the skull during the struggle of a street fight or something, you won't break your knuckles as much. It's good to practice hitting things without gloves, as well as having hand wraps with gloves, especially on a heavy bag. But other kinds of practice, you can have a smaller pad and punch with no gloves. And of course, we would like to break. We like to break boards in Taekwondo and bricks, and so this is going to help you be able to punch through boards better too. So, of course, any kind of flat stone. I found these outside. They work really good. I used to use this one a lot. This is pretty heavy, way heavier than these. This is a natural rock I found in Kentucky when I used to live there. Since then, I have this. It's kind of like a thing you can put a cup or something on for fun. But I used to punch on this flat part like that. So let me get a better angle. You see, like this. And then punching it in your hand. Punch, 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 punch. Now I use these flatter ones. Just because they're lighter does not mean they're not heavy and hard when you're punching. What I mean is the impact is heavy, not that they're heavy to hold. It really doesn't matter as long as it stops you and you can bash it on your knuckles here. Okay, and this one is bigger, a little heavier. I like this one the best. Okay, and then also you want to do these. My other hand conditioning video is more in depth, but I'm just showing you little things you can find. Also, I went to the Dollar Tree and I got this one here. It's a decoration for around Halloween, harvest time, Thanksgiving, and it was a dollar. It's plaster. It's not a real rock, but it has this nice flat part, and it's pretty heavy. It's about almost the same. This is still heavier, this one from Kentucky. These are some kind of garden type tools, stones that they put on walls or something, and they're just underground in Alabama. These are from Alabama. Okay. They're just in the dirt buried, and I found them, and I washed them off. Okay, so this one is pretty good to punch. So, boom, 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 boom. So you want to be able to do that, okay? And you do that for a little bit, maybe 3 to 5 minutes. Now, after you do a really good session, you're definitely going to want to rest for 1 day or 2 days before doing it again. You don't need to punch it for an hour or something stupid like that. Just do that, and then your regular training, which is like pad work, and you wear your gloves, you wear your hand wraps, that kind of stuff. So that's one thing you can do, and these are really cool tools. And then of course, put your hand like this, and then make sure it's flat. Hit. Okay, now this isn't the hardest surface, but if you put this on a harder table or just on the ground, like on your floor, or even on the patio or your garage floor, you can just pound, pound on top, pound on the other hand, pound, pound, pound. Okay, so show a better view. I'll put it on my leg so I can hit real hard. Okay, slap it like that. Just slap it a little bit. Now be careful not to keep your fingers up so you don't bash the edge into your fingers. That can cause a cut. It can also hurt. So you really want to keep it on top. And then if your finger, the knuckle part, flatten your hand really good and just hit slap, slap. Of course, it's more effective if you're on the ground, and I don't really have that space where I'm filming right now. Okay, so think of that. And then of course, you can just hold it. Just chill out. Oh, I'm watching a YouTube video right now. Just do this while you're watching the video. And make sure your knuckles are flat, not one knuckle at a time, but two at a time, two at a time, two at a time, okay? And then, knife hand it. You can even knife hand this curved part so you can bust through boards. All right, and I'll show you something else. When you're really advanced or more advanced at doing push-ups and things like that, and also hitting your hands against hard surfaces, you can try to do push-ups. Of course, the beginner is going to want to do it on just a mat or a carpet. So just like this, fist push-ups, or we call them black belt push-ups, that kind of thing. And you can do them this way. Okay. When you get more into it, that will strengthen your wrist and help you start out. Then when you get more into it, make sure this is on camera. Okay. And you don't have a hard surface like cement, and you only have carpet or something, you can use these rocks, the flat rocks I just showed you. So put your fists on it. Ready? And keep going. And if you want, you can do it this way. Okay? Just do it different ways. You know, do a couple sets of 10, something like that. Okay? And even just this act, sitting like this and putting your knuckles on something hard, is going to help you. Especially if you're in the beginning stages, it might hurt super bad. Just to tap it light, it might hurt really bad. But even this puts pressure on the knuckle and the skin and helps condition and make it stronger and less pain. So you could just do that. Then you could move it like that, grind it. And when I say grind it, I don't mean scrape it on your skin. No, just press and move it like that. It's just like doing that, okay? But it's with something hard. So you don't want to scrape your skin off. That's dumb. Or you want to try more cool stuff. And then after you do it, like, and it hurts, you just rub your knuckles. Oh, it hurts. Get them back. Ooh, you know, give you a little bit of relief. Stretch them. That kind of thing. Okay. Then you can do like a one. Just hold it. You can do this for a really long time. It's just that pressure is going to make your wrist strong too. Okay? Something like that. And try the other side. You can push up like that too. Okay. Or you can practice planks too. There's the plank, of course, that you just do this on the side. And of course, the more advanced plank where people do this. And then they tend to raise their leg up and everything. Well, why not do it on your hand, on your fist? Balance. And then you can get bored and go, oh, I'm going to the next one. Or whatever. And switch off. Okay? Of course, once you do an exercise like this, and let's say you're really sore, you might be sore for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever, how many days. So don't do any more hardcore, you know, hitting, conditioning type stuff until you feel completely healed and your hand does not hurt at all anymore. And then do it again, lightly, like we just did. The key is not going, it's just tap, 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 tap. Not as hard as you can punch, okay? It's not a Macho Man test. It's supposed to be very gradual. So try that stuff.